This is Business Avenue, a portal for relevant tidbits for your career and business. My name is Edmond Jamna, and I'm glad to welcome you to another episode. Okay, so over the past couple of weeks, we've been speaking about managing your finances effectively, with the objective of having your revenue superseding your expenses in order to arrive at a surplus so that you can save and further invest. Okay, so in one episode, we spoke about where you should increase your revenue when you deem your expenses as very, very necessary and cannot be reduced. And in another episode, we spoke about when the revenue have no chances of being increased, so you have to resort to reducing the expenses. Now, in this episode, we'll be talking about what you should do when you've been able to successfully achieve the equation, that is the surplus. Okay, so once you've been able to either increase your revenue and keep your expenses static, or hold on to your revenue and reduce your expenses, both ways achieving a surplus, you should be able to save the surplus. Okay, so you should always have a savings to investment mentality, not an expense one. Okay, so once you get a surplus, you should not create another expenditure avenue to just channel those surplus on. Neither are you supposed to migrate a need to a want, zeroing the surplus. So for example, you spend $2 on lunch, and because you have a surplus, you just increase it to $3 or $4. It is not prudent for you to do so. Now let's look at ways where you can successfully save and channel it into investments to create another cycle of revenue for you. Now the first thing you should do is that you should set an objective for your savings. Savings must not be arbitrary. Every money that you set aside, it should lead to a certain purpose. So you can choose to save towards your own education or that of your child. You can choose to save towards buying a new car or replacing the existing one. You can choose to plan towards your retirement or a vacation. It gives you the momentum. It sets the path. It gives you a goalpost for which you move towards. Okay. It doesn't allow for distractions to come your way and use your money unnecessarily. Okay. So once you've been able to set the savings target, you should further categorize them into short, medium, or long term. So a target is a short term when its realization is supposed to be within 0 to 24 months or within 2 years. A medium term is when it's supposed to be achieved within 2 to 5 years, and anything above 5 years will be considered long term. Okay. Once you've been able to categorize it, then you should invest based on the categories listed above. Now investment is very, very crucial, because savings is good, but it shouldn't be an end. When you save, it is like piling up stock or funds down. Once you do that, we have something we call time value of money. With the passage of time, the purchasing power of the monies that you have saved will reduce. So for example, $10,000 today will not be the same as $10,000 in a year's time. Though the amount will be there, but what it can get you will be different. So when you invest, in the worst case scenario, it will preserve the value of your money and will also bring you returns and make your life comfortable. And also, the investment must be based on the categories that we have listed. So if you are saving towards a short-term target, invest in a short-term portfolio. So for medium and long-term. Once you have been able to do that, do not terminate your investment before its maturity or redemption period. Investment managers or fund managers invest the money that you give to them in assets or portfolios based on the timeline that you agree with them. So if you give them funds to invest and you expect returns on your principal within 5 years, they also invest in assets that will take 5 years to turn around, get returns, and disburse some for you. So if you come within 2 years and you want to recoup your investments, your principal, first of all, you are saying that you are not ready to get your interest because their money has not worked the full cycle. Secondly, even if they give you your principal, the same amount as we spoke about, the purchasing power or the time value of money, would have reduced in its worth. Because if you had invested $10,000 and it's been 2 years and you're getting the same $10,000 back, that money would have reduced. Say it will be worth 9,000 in value or 8,000. And even in economies where it is very volatile, it is going to rapidly reduce. So after we've spoken about investments, let's look at portfolios or tenets that can help you to invest wisely and get the maximum return. Okay. So the first thing to note is that returns, which is the benefit you stand to gain on your investment, it can be profit, interest, or dividend, is positively correlated with risk. Risk is the uncertainty that your investment will yield a desired profit, and even in certain situations, you can have a reduced principal or lose it in totality. So when we say it is positively correlated, the higher the risk in an investment portfolio, the higher the return you stand to what derive. Okay, so let's say you are investing in an agricultural produce. There is a high risk that the rain might not fall. Even if the rain falls, there's no guarantee that the crops will yield fully. And even if they yield fully, there's no guarantee that the market will be available to absorb your goods. Okay, as compared to treasury bill. Treasury bill, no matter what you do, your principal and your interest will come to you. So in agriculture, there is a certain level of risk involved. So if you invest and the risk does not materialize, the return that you stand to gain will also be higher compared to a treasury bill where the risk is low. So the return that you get is also low. The second thing too that you must note is you must identify your risk profile. So a risk profile is the willingness or preparedness of an investor to accept a risk trade-off. So a risk trade-off is the balance between a return and the risk of an investment or a portfolio. So an investor can be a risk taker or have a high risk profile if he or she is attracted by the promise of a high return on an investment and is not bothered by the associated risk. So in the agricultural example that we cited, the investor sees the benefit of getting high profit on the investment that they are putting into the agriculture. Now, you are said to be risk averse or have a low risk profile if you are scared by the risk involved in a portfolio and makes you forfeit the promise of a higher return. So such a person will go in for investments that has the guarantee of they having their principal and their interest if possible. You invest based on your risk profile. Okay, there's nothing wrong in somebody being risk averse. There's nothing wrong with somebody being a risk taker. And when we talk about high risk, we're not talking about uncalculated risk. We're talking about a tendency of a produce not coming up or the desired result expected in an investment not yielding. Okay, so don't just invest in anything without making the necessary checks on it. Okay, let's look at avenues or areas where we can put our savings to yield us benefits. Okay, so if you are risk averse or you have a low risk profile and you want to invest in the short term, you can resort to savings accounts with the banks. You can also resort to treasury bills, whether the 30 days or the 91 days or the 182 days, based on the timeline that you have set for your target. You can also resort to fixed deposits. This ones guarantee you a fixed return and a guarantee that you get your principal back. If you are looking at investing in the short term and you are a risk taker or have a high risk profile, you can resort to trade with your money. And here you have to look at where is that can generate your principal or your capital and a possible interest that will tie into the timeline of your target. So if you're looking at getting the money within 6 months, you should invest or trade in goods that can allow you to get your principal and your profit back within the 6 months. Don't go beyond that, other than that you'll be in tight corner. You can also decide to go into agriculture with those monies, and again you should choose crops that have a yielding turn around that will tie into the timeline set with your target. Okay, with a medium term, if you are risk averse, you can also choose a savings account. You can leave the money to stay in the account. You can also roll over your treasury bill and your fixed deposits. Okay, if you are a risk taker or have a high risk profile, you can also trade with your money, again being cautious of the timeline of the goods and that of the targets. Okay, you can also do agricultural activities. You can invest in shares. And lastly, for the long term, if you are risk averse, you can also continue with your savings account. You can invest in fixed deposits. You can roll over your treasury bill. Okay, if you have a high risk profile or you are a risk taker, you can invest in real estate. You can invest in agriculture. You can take up insurance policy, the life assurance or the life insurance policies. You can invest in equity, that is buying shares. Okay, so once you've been able to invest rightly, then you'll feel comfortable in allowing your money to go through the cycle and bring you the maximum benefits possible. Okay. So guys, this is where we are going to draw the curtains down on our discussion. Okay, if you have any inquiries or you have any questions to ask, don't hesitate to put them in the comment section below and it will be addressed appropriately. Also that, we'll crave your indulgence to hit the red subscribe button, click on the notification bell to be abreast with our postings on time, like and share. Join us again on another episode of Business Avenue. Till then, take care of yourself and stay blessed. Adios.